It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mads Maddest writer Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1603, recorded Thursday, December 29th, 2016. The best and worst of 2016. On this episode of the Giz Wiz, we have the best and worst of the past year. Viewers sent in their suggestions, and me and Dick chose our favorites as well. All next on the last episode of 2016!
It's the same show with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease,
a nerd pathology,
rows and rows of USBs, growing LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now it is time for the Giz Wiz, and here he is, the go-to guy for gadgets, Dick DeBartolo. How you doing, Dickie D?
I'm doing fine, Chad, and you, sir?
I am doing fantastic as well. I have a little bit of a cold, but still doing fantastic.
Oh, okay. Yeah, anytime you seem to leave your house, you come back with a cold.
I know. Yeah. Anytime I leave the germ-free zone of my home and venture out into the world, I get some sort of sickness, either convention or something in it.
Airplanes, and now obviously you must get sick in cars because you just drove.
I just drove down to Austin.
Yeah.
You know, anytime around, at home, you know, not a lot of people come to my house. I don't get
maybe
introduced to many germs. So when I'm out and about traveling, I guess I just can't handle it. I just get sick.
Well, when you come to New York, I can introduce you to some germs.
See, and that's what happens. And that's why I get sick. Yeah. And it's the same thing. It's this running nose and I don't know. It's funny because I do know if, for instance, like, oh, I'm sick right now. I don't feel well. I'm like, well, what symptoms do you have? Because you're not showing anything. I can tell you, I've been blowing my nose all day long. It's been hard to wake up, achy, and everything. So, anyway.
But you're a trooper.
We're keeping on.
So, answer one question. What gadget did you get for Christmas?
I got a lot of gadgets for Christmas, let me tell you, because my parents know I do this show. And, in fact, when we poll the patrons at the end of this month, I'm going to put a category as gadgets I got for Christmas, because I got, of course, you know, now with the new home, I got tons of kitchen gadgets. I have little silly gadgets. I have gadgets for this show specifically. I got at least three that are jumping to mind immediately. Very small. You know, it's crappy corner stuff, so it's like under $5. I definitely got some. I kind of don't want to reveal any of them because I might be showing them next month, possibly, if the patrons vote on it. Yeah.
No, but I always get nothing because all my friends go, well, you've been doing this for 20 years, you must have everything, so we didn't bring anything.
Right, have a shirt.
Becky sent me stuff, and I think this was in Ranger Rick's thing. When I opened it, I said, Turtles? Why would someone give me something from the Turtles? And then I realized what it was. Does it look familiar?
It's teenager. Oh, it's the hover. It's the copter that didn't have a remote. You'd use your hand to kind of keep
it
floating.
Yes, exactly.
From Five Below.
Five Below.
Yeah.
See, so people do care.
I saw that on Instagram. Scott Johnson, who does Frog Pants Network, he said, you know, this was a big hit this year, and it was that. It was the I forget the exact name of that.
The Heli Ball.
Heli Ball, there you go.
Heli Ball, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Heli Ball.
Yeah, he did an Instagram post on how that was a big hit at his holidays. So I thought that was really cool. Interesting. That's great.
So it's great. All right, Jess, should we jump in and do this thing?
Let's jump in. So this episode is the best and the worst of 2016. And it's kind of in no particular order. We kind of have some themes, but...
No, we sort of... and I have more best ofs only because I do three gadgets on every show and Chad does one. So it's not that we that I'm saying right. I do get to do more, but right. I just had more to do. Okay, so the absolute best gadget. This is Trent Young writing. The absolute best gadget from the show were the reading glasses from Thin Optics. I use them daily. They are very durable. I love them. And that's from Trent Young. I do a show with a guy named Stu Shostak. And he does a show on people in the entertainment business of old. But at the end of the year, we do a show on gadgets. And he goes through my website. And Stu said, the best thing you showed in 2016 were Thin Optics. And in case you don't remember, the newest version of them is the keychain version. So this has a little hole there. It comes with a link so you can put the ring in it and then put it on your keychain. And if you need, you left your glasses at home, you have an instant pair of magnifiers. Very easy to carry with you. And they're very cheap. They come in a lot of different, they come in a little wallet pack. They come in a phone case, so it's built right into the phone case. They make them so that you can glue them onto anything you want, or this little key thing, and they range from about $20 to $40, depending on what you want to use it for. And I recommend getting them from the company website, because there's what it looks like attached to my – I actually have a pair on my phone. At the company website, you get an extra fee, a free pair of glasses. So that's why I say look for them at thinoptics.com. You can always check Amazon first to see if they are offering the same thing for less. But and also, they're guaranteed for life. They have a – if you can break them and – let me just go
if
back.
If you can break them.
If you can break them. Just cut back to me again. I mean, look at that amp. Whoops. I bent them and they sprung out of my hand. They're polycarbonate and titanium, I think. So very rugged and fairly inexpensive, and they come in three or four magnifications.
And you can wear them on either side. There's no sort of over-the-ear.
Exactly. Yeah, you pull them out and you pinch them, and I'm going to – hang on. I'm bending down.
He's going to get them. And remember, by the way, these were at the very beginning of 2016. We covered them at CES 2016.
Yes, so. Right. But then the keychain version came out in the summer.
Right, exactly.
So, right. And I'll show you how I use a pair of them with a gadget that is my favorite of yours for 2016.
That's a little tease for later on in the episode of how these can be used later on. So Thin Optics, which you can find at thinoptics.com. I believe that we may have lost Dickie D here. This is a viewer very favorite gadget of 2016. I think we got you back, Dick.
Okay, very good. So did you hear that part about Fasta Pasta?
No, jump into Fasta Pasta.
All right, very good. So Ben from Omaha says the best gadget of 2016 was Fasta Pasta. I got it as a gift, and I like it. And Fasta Pasta, we talked about a couple of years ago, but then this year they introduced Fasta Pasta Family. And this is a way to – maybe you just show a quick picture of it. This is a way to just throw cold water and pasta in a – there you go, in that pan. Put it in the microwave. It tells you the amount of minutes to do it. And you – when it's done, the pasta's cooked. You put the lid back on. The lid has a colander in it. You pour the water out. And if you do buy it, shoot me an email after you look at the lid, because the lid, the instructions say for a small portion, use whole one. For a large portion, use whole two. But the lid says, strangely, one and three. So I called the company and I said, am I missing something here? And they said, oh, you're one of the few people who actually realized that. We didn't realize that until we were shipping them after the first production run and realized they had messed up. and the next production run will indeed say hole 1 and 2. But
there's the three.
Okay. you came in right at the right time. Pasta realize it's an error. And
you may have one of the exclusive three-hole Fosta right, Pasta. Right. And this is a gadget you use all the time, right?
All the time. Either I use it or Dennis uses it. It is so easy. No pots, no colander. You just fill it with cold water, throw in the pasta, look on the chart for how many servings you're making, set your microwave. And the first 1 or 2 times you make it, you'll probably learn how your microwave behaves, because some people have 1,000 watts, some people have 1,500 watts. But once you learn the exact timing, it is a breeze to make pasta. And then, as I said, after the pasta is done, you put the lid back on, pour the water out through the lid. So pretty much trouble-free. I like it a lot. $15 for the little original guy and $20, $19.99 for the new pasta
family.
Exactly.
You know, these alliteration gadgets.
Yes, I know.
Pasta, pasta.
I know, because when you look at it, you're saying, wait a minute, why isn't it faster pasta?
Faster pasta. Well, you're the master of the faster pasta.
I am. worst game.
Yeah, let's get into some worst. We've had some greats.
Worst from Rick Lohr, L-A-W-R. Out loud, that game where you insert something in your mouth and say a phrase is dangerous. Well, actually, the game is called Speak Out from Hasbro. But I think there was a game called Out Loud, and I think Hasbro actually bought Out Loud and sells it now as Speak Out after repackaging it. Now, Chad found great video demo.
I did.
All right, so I'll just explain. So you have this weird, I had it here and I don't know. I rearranged my desk and, oh, here it is. All right, so let me just show you. That's not the right thing. All right, it's a plastic thing. You put it in your mouth like that, okay? That's what you look like. And then you have to read phrases off a card, and your teammates have to identify what you're saying. So this is someone from Time to Play magazine showing you how attractive you look when you have this thing in your mouth.
You have no lip motion.
You've
only have teeth and tongue, and it's just
Right. But then Chad found this video of an older guy playing.
Confusing.
Turkey.
So his dentures have fallen out.
His dentures are on the floor.
And the children in the room just can't handle. I don't think they understood they were dentures. Grandpa's falling apart! Quick! Oh my gosh! Call an ambulance!
Oh my god. I have so much teeth work done, I would never chance it that something would fall out, nor do I want to open my mouth wide enough for people to look into my mouth.
That was Speak Out from Hasbro.
Hasbro and Rick Lohr, L-A-W-R, said that is a dangerous game.
Boo!
Okay, my favorite game of the year. Last year we had Pie Face, and this year I think it's the same company, Zing, if I recall right. They came out with a game called Wethead, and the people there, that's Wethead, and the people there are very clever because they produce this little 90-second commercial for Wethead.
It's pretty good. It's a really good commercial.
It really
is. We're going to go ahead and play most of it.
Okay.
I'll try to make it big here for us.
Back so soon?
You know what I want.
A Hello Kitty backpack.
You won't be making jokes much longer.
So you fill Wethead with cold ice water.
It's like the smoke that they added.
Shut up and give me the password now! Type it!
When am I supposed to use my nose?
Oh, enough. You want to play games? I like to play games.
You'll never give it up.
And they use the little spinny thing from the game.
Yeah, isn't that funny?
I think it's funny.
Now, one rod is going to release the cold water on the guy's head.
Too bad.
Oh no, here comes the kingpin!
Honey, is everything okay down there?
Everything's fine, Mom, we're just playing.
Okay, well, just play nice.
Okay.
And then she shuts the light and it's back to James Bond.
Yeah, exactly, it's back to the interrogation. Oh, he got it!
Yeah, he got it! Cold water.
Yeah, that's a pretty funny video from Wethead.
It's a very funny video, and amazingly, the thing is down to $9.
Yeah, that's like the least expensive physical game for a party I've seen in a long time.
And it's Prime, Amazon Prime, so free shipping if you're a Prime member. I got pretty good reviews. 66.
It's amazing reviews, 4.2 stars out of 5.
That is great idea, great fun.
Yeah, very good. A great summer game, of course.
I love people put reviews up and the pictures sideways.
Yeah, I know. I don't... there's some things Amazon still has. It seems so old.
I know.
It's like, why isn't this... And then the bad picture viewer, and I can't tell you how many times I've clicked one of these, and their arrows are the lightest gray. And so, like, right there, on this image...
Oh, yes.
There's white right there. I can't tell that there's an arrow right there.
You have to guess. Or you wouldn't even know that there were more photos in that direction.
Exactly. Yeah, they have some pretty crummy stuff on Amazon sites sometimes. But, yeah, $9, Prime, and a really, really good game, and perfect for summer, pool... No, you know, that would just be great. So, Wethead.
Wethead.
From Zing.
And a very funny commercial.
Yeah, and a very funny commercial, of course. Okay, some more great things. Some more great things. This is me and one of our favorite things that we covered on the Giz Wiz that we thought was just so clever.
Exactly. And this is another one from Rick Laura, LAWR. He said there were so many best things, the coding toys, STEM Bobby, where Bobby would make different inventions and contraptions. I love the pet maze. If you don't remember the pet maze, this is a way, like Charlie, if you put down a chicken stick, he'll eat it in about 15 seconds. But if you break it into little pieces and throw it into a pet maze, it takes him 45 seconds. Okay. And they come in all different maze forms. You can find them on Amazon. Just type in pet maze. And it does let Charlie slow down. I'm just going to look at my notes here for 1 second because Rick sent me an email, which I didn't have a chance to put on the website yet. He said, I gave my nieces 7-4 the Fisher Caterpillar and STEM Bobby. The Caterpillar is from Fisher-Price, where kids make like a caterpillar, and the way they click things together is the way they can see the computer act on the screen. It's just amazing stuff for kids. He also liked the folding bike. And that made me think of two gadgets from the bike show I thought were amazing. I think this is the cleverest thing in bikes ever, maybe. And that's called Rack Stand. And here's a quick thing from the inventor.
Oh, here, let me grab.
Yeah, that's okay. Yep, no problem.
There you go. Is it this video that you were on?
Yeah, a minute, 12 seconds.
Dickie Bartolo,
like
man's meta try to end the Giz Wiz. One take theater here at gizwiz.tv. Montague bikes, great folding bikes, but we're here with David Montague because this caught my eye. It is a bike rack with a big difference, and David is going to demo it and tell us about it.
Sure. Well, it's basically in this position, you can see it is a luggage carrier, so you put your luggage on here. In addition, it is also a fender. You can see the fender through here, so that stops the rain and mud from getting on you when you're riding. And then There's a little latch right here. You just unlatch the latch, and it is a kickstand in this position. And finally, if you want to work on your drivetrain of your bike, it's a work stand in this position. So it's four things in one.
Four things in one. This is really great. And the price is?
It's under $100 for retail.
Under $100. Montague Bikes, and it's called Rack Stand. I like this a lot. Dickie Bartolo, Mad's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz. One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv at Interbike.
So I actually got my parents, me, my sister, and her girlfriend, went in together and got my parents a bike this Christmas. That was their
oh,
big...
Oh, my word.
Yeah, Christmas gift. And so it did have a fender and all that. I had forgotten about this gadget and kind of wish that we had installed one ourselves.
Well, you know what? They said it would be coming soon, but I just see info on their website. But I do not yet see a buy button.
Oh, good. Okay.
So it is not in production yet. Actually, what they're doing is installing it on the bikes that they're selling. And then when they catch up, they will be making it as an option for people to put on other bikes. So it's very clever.
It's very, very clever.
Yeah,
and I was wondering if this was a self-install or, something that was already on the bike.
Yeah, it's both. It comes on most of their bikes, but then you can install it. The guy told me pretty easily.
That's good. That's good. So that was the Rack Stand.
The Rack Stand. Then I found something else called Visit Jack's. And I have a little video. We can just do the first 50 seconds, and you'll instantly see how clever this is.
Hey, Dickie Bartolo, Man's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz. One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. If this looks familiar, I think we showed it a couple years ago. It was like a prototype. Well, now it's in the marketplace, and we're going to talk to Gary, who's over here. Follow the bouncing lights. Gary, how you doing?
Hi, how you doing?
Good to see you. So, Gary, this is on the marketplace now. And I think when it first came out, it was going to be like hundreds of dollars. What is this retail for?
It's retailing $85 now.
$85. This is a great way to be noticed. You know, I didn't even look. Am I lit in the back?
You certainly are.
Okay.
So lift your arm up and look. People can see what you're doing from behind as well. Either arm. Put your arm back down. And it continues to indicate for 5 seconds, and it'll turn off eventually. There you go. Perfect safety.
This is really great. Now,
we can go out there.
Okay, cool. Yeah, so it's the most visible jacket I've ever seen.
Absolutely. However, and I also showed this on ABC, it has gone up in price a lot.
Yeah, because $85.
It was $85, and now on the company website, it is $120.
And that's after discounted from $145.
Yes. Over at Amazon, it was $85, and it went to $149.99.
I think these became popular, because at at that price, and I think I remember saying it on the show,
that
that price, most jackets don't cost that much.
No, exactly. It's very, very clever that those turn signals are automatic, and the black one, when it's not, you can actually just shut the little power supply off and use it as a jacket, although you'll see the LEDs, they'll be a lot less noticeable when they're not lit. But even at $120 to $116, it seems pretty reasonable.
Yeah, I agree. I remember us covering this on the show and just thinking, man, like, I don't even bike, but I want to get one of these because it seems so nice.
I know, I want to get one, and I want to when I talk to people, I want to point. I was going to say, oh, I'm going that way. And then I'm going to pick up some milk, and then I'll be going that way.
It's great for a tour guide, like at a museum.
Oh, perfect.
Everyone follow me. Follow me. I have the blinking jacket right here.
You're absolutely right. That's perfect.
Yeah.
That's Visit Jack's. Now we have the best and the worst from Dave Martell. By the way, I have a couple of emails from people who said, I'm not sure when this was, but they were not within this year. So we are sticking with everything that we showed in 2016. Dave Martell says, the greatest gadget I saw on the show and purchased this year is the Kangaroo Pocket PC. I'm still using it and loving it. Dave Martell, the Kangaroo is the little guy. It's like the size of a paperback book. He's putting it in his, in a pocket. Obviously, it's got to be a big pocket. But it's Windows 10. You can carry it, unlike the PC stick. This also has a built-in battery, can run for 4 hours, sells for $99. And now on Amazon, there's a new version that came in at $200, but I notice it's down now to about $149. It actually clicks on to the original Kangaroo. And if you go down a little, you can see what they've added some. It makes it double thick, but there's an extra USB, I think 3.0. You can hardwire an internet cable if you want. There's several other, I forgot what, I think they added another card slot.
Oh, micro SD, it looks
micro
like.
Micro SD. The original one didn't have an audio jack, which the new one has. So if you're interested, look at the newer version, which originally was double the price, but now it's just $50 extra. So that's the Kangaroo.
Interesting. PC. It's like it's basically the size of a phone, but it doesn't have the screen and has it packs more horsepower. So and the Pro is double thick, so it's, you know, twice a kind of a large chunky phone.
Yeah.
But it's a whole computer.
It's a whole computer, and it comes with a little dongle at the end that's very clever. Is they sell separate dongles, I think, for $35 or $40, which hook up to your keyboard, your mouse, your monitor. And so the plan is you could have one and leave it at the office hooked up to a the keyboard, the mouse, the monitor, and then just carry the little it's way up at the top there. You can see what the PC looks like when it doesn't have the dongle attached to it. And it, yes, that's it. So it's even smaller. Then come home, slip it in there. It's now working with your home system. Take it, go to your office, click it in, and then it's working with your office system. So it's really neat.
And for someone who's just basically doing email, you know, a lot of people at work, you're not doing a ton with your computer. You know, you just kind of need something that you can type. You basically need a smart typewriter in most cases. and be able to play some web video and things like that. But you're not going to be editing a video or doing anything high performance. It's perfect. $169 for the Pro.
For the Pro and $99 for the original guy.
Right.
Exactly. Now, Dave, you'll have to fill us in here, Chad. Dave Martell says the worst thing was Chad's cheap smartwatch.
And I got it right here.
Okay, but we liked it, didn't we?
So, we enjoyed this smartwatch. And what it is it's a little, it was called the Panadu? U8 is what it was in here. I can show it to you right here. And you had a whole bunch of different little features. It kind of felt like Android inside of there, because you have a little back button, you have a menu button, and you still have a few things like running and a timer, and you have a few apps in here. And originally we really, really liked it. We thought that this was super duper cool, but then I remember the next episode we got a buyer beware email saying that these little smartwatches were known to take people's information or talk back to a server that wasn't really authorized. And so we kind of, you know, took that with a grain of salt, but also kind of looked at this again with a fresh eye and thought, well, maybe this isn't the best gadget. And then we got even more emails saying that, well, of course it's talking back to a server because it sets its own clock. So that's a server clock. So nothing to be scared about.
Okay.
So I've heard so much conflicting information about these guys. They're super duper cheap. I mean, look, it's a smart watch, right? Color screen, touch color screen. It has a few features built in. It works over Bluetooth, so basically everything you do via Bluetooth. It has an app for iPhone and Android, and so you could do things like use your watch to take a camera photo just by basically doing a selfie stick action of creating that like Bluetooth shutter. It has barometer, sleep trackers, dialers, and of course you could take and receive phone calls from it, which weren't super great. But the crazy thing was it was under $20. So right here, this is the one that I bought. It's $18.99. So super inexpensive.
Yeah.
For what
and
you
we
get.
We should warn people that while you were showing it, someone said, "Oh, I found it for 12. Oh, I found
right.
it for 4. Oh, I found it for 2."
People kept going down and down in price until that
yes,
2.
Yes, but it turned out that many of the like the $2 and $4 ones were scams.
Right.
Where they were billed immediately. They immediately someone said, as soon as I ordered it, I immediately got a tracking number and it never, ever came. And then they did some research and found out that there was just someone collecting $2 and $4 and sending you a tracking number that didn't particularly track anything.
Right.
So be very careful of the, you know, the if it sounds too good to be true.
Probably is.
It is. But yeah, Chad paid... You paid $18, right?
Yeah, $18 yeah. for it, and it's pretty fancy. You know, I haven't really worn it day to day. I never felt like that was really needed, but it does have some smartwatch features, which are pretty great, and it charges over USB, mini USB, so you know, not too difficult to use. Yeah, and I believe it worked better with Android phones than it did with iOS phones because of Android is just a little more open, could capture things like messages and stuff like that. But yeah, it was I thought it was pretty okay, but then there was a lot of scares around it that there was all the scams and possibly was talking to some server, and it's difficult to understand exactly, you know, what the motivations of it being so inexpensive were and stuff like that. So I believe that's why it's on the not so great
list
of things.
Okay. Well, now something that Chad showed that I thought was great, bought one, and think it is an amazing value. So, Chad, tell us about your sun.
My fancy sunglasses.
Whoa!
Oh, yes.
Whoa!
So, this was for Bluetooth month, and these are the One Fast Bluetooth sunglasses, and they have so many different features in them. We covered this, it's almost been like 6 months now that we cover this. Inside, you get a pair of smart sunglasses that can connect to your phone via Bluetooth. They have the little headphones that can move around, so they kind of have a little bit of play, and you can move them back and forth just a little bit. You also get buttons on the top for multimedia, play, pause, forward, and back. Play, pause is just a single button. And then the lenses can flip up out of the way, and you also get extra lenses with it. So you can get some dark brown, you get some yellow, and you get clear lenses. And those will remove with just a few screws. I believe it's just two different screws. Yep, at the front of the glasses. They charge with a mini USB, not a micro, a mini, which is kind of the older, outdated version of USB that's kind of fading out. You may have trouble finding one of those cables. And it came with a nice fancy case and a microfiber cloth. This thing, I thought, was you just got so much for the cost. It ended up being under $20, $16 for these sunglasses. And just Bluetooth headphones at $16 ain't too bad. But having it all built into some sunglasses that had nice buttons and lenses, I thought that this was just such a great buy. And you use them all the time.
I use them at the gym. And the funny thing is, they're on crooked because of my headsets. The thing is, I like to have some kind of magnifier on. So these obviously don't have built-in magnifiers. So what I do is I wear a pair of thin optics under them.
There you go. Double up on your gadgets.
And when I slide them all the way back, no one knows I have these thin optics on. And I can see fine, but yet have my Bluetooth headphone. And the sound is very decent. I mean, I was really amazed for, what were they, $17? I can't even remember. I know you just said it.
Yeah, $16.88.
So that is my favorite thing from you.
The OneFast Bluetooth. This is one of those Amazon gadgets where the
endless title
the title goes on and on and on. Talking about trying to do that search engine optimization there. But yeah, these, and they come in different colors too, a ton of different colors. I got mine in red, you got yours in black. Looks like they come in silver and some blue and just all sorts of crazy paint jobs with the glasses.
It's just great.
But yeah, for under $20, some Bluetooth sunglasses that have headphones built in and a lot of nice little features. That was one of our best crappy corners this year. So,
okay.
There we go.
Well, I'm gonna skip the Panono and go right to your crappiest, and I'm using your quote
I wrote it down. The crappiest crappy corner gadget we had this
year ever
had to be. This was during, I believe it was Science Month, possibly. I forget which month it was, but it was the electric airplane launcher. This was a DIY kit where you got all the pieces, and it was made to launch paper airplanes into the sky. And I happen to have, here, let me get a bit of paper. I don't want to fold that up. We got some other paper right here.
Not your last will and testament.
No, exactly. I need that. This looks like an old ad here. And it just were, first off, the creation process was a pain. As a 20-something, I had a hard time putting this together. I can't imagine a child.
And that man is a professional.
I've put one or two gadgets together in my day.
You are a professional.
It was just very, very difficult. And then the other thing that just killed me was we were trying to figure out why on the box, which I don't happen to have anymore, the front of the airplanes were square. Do you remember that?
Yes, I remember. And then I remember we found out why.
It has in the instructions that for safety reasons, you must cut off the front of every airplane. There's the square, the square-tipped airplane launcher, which, of course, you almost have to create a completely different airplane situation in order to, a new airplane design that has a square tip at the front of it. And then just at the end of the day, you know, here's an airplane I just made in a few seconds. It seems to fly just fine with just a toss. I don't want to toss it too hard because I won't be able to get it back. I'm wired into the Giz Wiz set. And so I've added some more batteries into the device. It whirs up.
Whoa.
Yeah, there it goes.
I like the sound.
And then you're supposed to fit this airplane in. And I, for the life of me, this thing just would not launch airplanes very well. It's very finicky. This is so much better than hand launching it. Let me tell you. I just hated this thing.
Do you remember what it cost?
Yeah, the price ended up being around $14. It was $13.45. So that's the crazy thing. $13 for this piece of junk, and this cost $16. This is Bluetooth smartwatch, right? I'm trying my best here to get a perfect launch.
Maybe Houston, no, Dallas, we have a problem.
There we go. It moves away from me, too.
It's getting away.
Okay, here we go.
Maybe that's it. Maybe you have to hold the airplane and launch the launcher.
it's, oh man, this was just such a crummy DIY. Oh, that was the other thing. You put something in the middle of it, and the little motors can't take it. They've just stopped. And so you have to let it out, and then it spins back up again.
Scotty, we need more power. This
I'm giving her all she's got, Captain.
Maybe you should make it with toilet paper.
Oh my gosh, this is just so crummy. Yeah, it's the worst. It's just the absolute worst gadget we've ever covered here on the Giz Wiz. I just hate it. It does happen to look a little bit like a face, and I used the engraver, which may have been another worst gadget we ever covered on the Giz Wiz, to engrave a little mouth on it. There you go. Yeah, so he looks happy to see you. This gadget was so bad that immediately after the Giz Wiz, I made sure to harvest its batteries, because the batteries were worth more to me than the actual gadget, and I had to go find some batteries before the show to make sure that it would work. So that was the 4M electric plane launcher kit. You too can have a horrible gadget in your home for a little less than $14. Although I don't recommend it.
Let's see. Some people liked it, right? It got
three stars out of 80 reviews.
I don't get that.
But you look, the reviews.
Oh, 14% of five stars. Oh my word!
You know, it is a little disconcerting, because you look at this and you think, you know, 3 out of 5, that ain't bad. It's better. It's
until
more than
you look
half.
At the numbers.
Until you actually look at the distribution.
Yeah. I usually add 4 and 5 stars to sort of get a vague idea. But if you add 4 and 5 stars here, you only get 28%.
Yeah. Yeah. Not so great. So, yeah. Fun. This was written by the owners of the company. Look at that. So that was my, by far, one of the worst gadgets that I covered here on the Giz Wiz, was the do-it-yourself airplane launcher. You know what? Let's move it from one of the worst. Let's have some happy times. What's one of your favorites?
A gadget that came out in spring that I really loved from Capresso. Their Ultima Pro, and this is a cappuccino and demi-tasse maker that is stainless, and it has lights and a frothing rod. And Capresso is a very high-end machine. They make them into the thousands, and this is their under $200 machine. And I use that about twice a week, and it makes great coffee. And what I've been doing lately is brewing coffee and then making a cup of espresso and throwing that into the brewed coffee. And you have a morning brew that gets you up and going.
This looks so good. I mean,
it is
have an actual frothing rod on a itty-bitty espresso maker.
Yeah, that's the other great thing is, you know, we have a very small kitchen and a very small footprint. The tamper and the rod and the measuring cup and everything fit under the lid. The top actually warms up so you can keep cups warm up. It's very cleverly designed.
And the big buttons too. These big, easy
big
to use
buttons. Back illuminated. Very good. And that's Capresso Ultima Pro. Became available in March, and it's under $200.
Under $200 for an espresso maker. That's pretty good.
An espresso maker.
And
now,
go ahead.
A gadget that, as I was talking about it, the chat room was going boo.
This would be chat room's choice as the chat room's disliked gadgets of 2016.
Fan hands.
So the chat room hated these.
You know what? Actually, if anybody had these and I was at a sports event, I would be unhappy too. Oh, they've even gone down less in price. So depending on the color, they could be as little as $3 or as much as $20. They are gloves. They are your clap enhancing gloves, because all those white blotches are plastic plates. And the object here is, instead of just applauding for your team, you clap these together. I couldn't stand them so much, I gave them to some kid, so I don't have mine here.
On the street, you didn't even know who he was. Here, get these out of my sight.
I said, hey, kid, you want some fan hands?
You want some annoying gadgets? Here you go.
Some annoying. Well, a kid wouldn't think they were annoying. He would probably think they were great. So fan hands, they're still around, and they're still available in many colors, but that was...
So the object was you slap your hands together, and the plastic bits smack each other. These white sections are it's kind of hard to tell because of the photos. But that's little bits of plastic. And
yes.
So instead of just a normal
clap,
you get a smack from the two pieces of plastic colliding. Right.
And as I recall, the plastic down by your palms, which is a big piece of plastic, is in different levels so that when they hit together, there can be like an echo in the plastic. So instead of just applauding, you can... You could, someone in the chat room says, these could be weaponized.
Yeah.
One liked these.
Yeah, the chat room was, it's like taking a phone call on an airplane. It's like,
yes.
Nobody wants to be next to that guy who's sitting, talking on the phone. Buy, sell, no, how dare you? On an airplane, they don't want to be next to the person in the stadium with the clapping hands. So.
And why are airplanes still considering that the next step be to let people make
the
phone
only
calls?
Thing I can think of is there is some money to be made. Is AT&T can say, oh, go ahead and make a phone call from the sky. It'll cost you $3 a minute. That's the only thing I can think of.
No, please, airlines, no calls in the sky.
None.
Then Kitron, we're not going to run the video, has dirty word in it, but he said this is the worst gadget. He fortunately got his money back. His fell apart.
This gadget was an LED light that also has a bug zapper built in, and we covered this.
Yeah.
And then about 2-3 weeks later, Kithron said, this thing fell apart. I could have been shocked. It could have caused a fire. So this is another gadget that the chat room
Now, mine
disliked.
Did not fall apart, but the bug part gave up. But unfortunately, the bug part gave up like 8 weeks in. And I think you had 2 months to return it, whatever it was. I was a week beyond being able to get my money back. Then I got a letter saying that the pest bug thing was defective and please call this number, and I called this number and I didn't have the right serial number, so she said, no, you can't get a refund. I said, but it doesn't work. And she said, well, we can't help that because many of us made the same bulb. And she said, my company is the only one refunding people who got them directly from us. And your serial number doesn't fall within the ones we shipped, so you're stuck.
You misheard her. She said, your serial number doesn't fall within the one we shipped. We only shipped one.
That's right.
Exactly. That's if your serial number had to be 0001,
and then
you could have gotten a refund.
Exactly.
So, yeah.
And then... We're down to your, so I like the, my Compresso Pro, and I like your glasses. Your favorite thing of 2016, your favorite gadget that you showed.
So I looked everywhere for this gadget because after we showed it, so this gadget was, I believe also, we may have been part of Science Month as well. We had a lot of interesting Science Month gadgets. But this was the... newer NEEWER 60 to 100x optical zoom for your iPhone. When I got this in, it didn't work, and the light at the front didn't turn on, and I was very confused by it. But as I started to show it on the Giz Wiz, it started to work, and I started to figure out just how fun it was. So you can actually see. If you go back and watch the episode 1574, you'll actually see me fall in love with this gadget. I couldn't find the gadget because I took it all around the house and looked at stuff with it. And I've since put it somewhere and can't find it. But It is basically a microscope that you attach to the front of your phone using a little clip. There it is right there. It has a little light to make sure that the phone actually gets enough light to see what you're showing off. It includes a few batteries in there. And then you have a little microscope that you can look at things on your phone. It's super portable. You can see right here, we're looking at a dollar. We're looking at some money. And I found this so fascinating.
Whoa, look
yeah,
at that.
That's some of the ink on a $1 bill, I believe. And I took this around and looked at some of the sheets and looked at my fingertip. And in a screenshot of this episode, I was, you know, looking at my taste buds. And I just found this was one of the coolest and most surprising gadgets of 2016.
Was it only for iPhones, Chad?
It would snap onto any phone. Enough. Basically, there was a little clamp that just kind of pinched it to the front of your camera.
Oh, okay.
So as long as your phone has enough space for that clamp to grab hold, it would work just fine. But I thought this would also be perfect for kids. You know, give them this, let them go outside, look at plants and bugs and all sorts of stuff. And it was just so interesting. There were two knobs on the side that one did the angle and one did the focus. So one could zoom in from 60 to 100x and one would focus on where you had landed. And I just thought it was just such an interesting gadget, and I really did fall in love with it. I took it downstairs and I looked at all sorts of stuff. I looked at, you know, I have, you know, got some new sheets, looked at the sheets. I looked at my countertop. You could look at coins and see all the scratches in the coins. I just really found this gadget to be super duper fun. You get it on Amazon for $8. $8 for this.
I know. I think you paid more, didn't you?
I think I did.
You know, I think when I was looking through past shows, I think yours was almost double that, or maybe $14 or something.
Right.
But boy, that's a heck of a buy.
Yeah, exactly.
And also, you know, if you want to go into counterfeiting, this might be a good
Easy. You know, if you need to, check the ink stains on your bills so you can properly counterfeit them.
Yeah.
There's no better product than this one right here. So that was the newer NEEWER 60 to 100x optical zoom. It calls it a little microscope. And I found that it was just so fun. Now, then there's a whole bunch of other ones as well. There's tons of different versions of this. This one's another one under $8. Rated pretty well at 65 reviews. It looks a little more compact, so that may actually be a little bit better for you. But yeah, I was just really, really, really impressed with it. And I mean, seriously, during that episode, you could see me going, I don't know about this, and then going, oh, wow. Oh, that's really cool. Oh, that's neat. And then falling more and more in love with this crappy gadget as the episode went on. I think we spent way too much time on it in that episode. But yeah, that was the newer.
Well, you know what? Spike in the chat room, this was on my list, but I thought the show was going to run long, so I didn't put it on. But what was the light that Spike said he loved the LED bright stick? Was that the thing that you put on the garage that was solar-powered?
Oh, the LED bright stick?
Yeah.
Are you talking about the Everbright?
Is it Everbright?
Yeah, the Everbright was an outdoor indoor. I happen to have the packaging right here, but I don't see the actual device. This used a solar panel at the top of the light to recharge it every night, and then it would use a motion detector to make it even brighter whenever you walked by. And at night, it would turn on at a dim setting, and when you walked by, it would turn on to a high setting. This is an as-seen-on-TV gadget for our stocking stuffer month. That was the Everbright. And maybe that was what Spike was talking about.
Someone else said the shoelaces. I think, were you talking about the shoelaces that you just pop into the eyelets?
And yeah, those were covered very recently. And I happened to see a a Shark Tank episode with a very similar product. It was funny. They were actual shoelaces not made out of the rubber. And they asked him, are there any competitors? And he says, I have the patent for the actual shoelaces, but other companies are making it out of latex. And I was like, wow, we just covered that on the Giz Wiz earlier.
Wow.
And thought, interesting. So, yeah, so those are really neat. Is there anything else from the chat room that the chat room really liked?
Spike said he was talking about the 120-volt light bulb.
The bright
stick. I don't know. Was that the Cree thing that I covered? I'm not sure. We covered all. Someone else said everything LED. That would be about 50% of everything I talked about.
We could just do an LED gadget show.
We could.
Yeah.
We could.
I absolutely adore LED things. Let me quickly look and see if I can find this. Oh, I think I know what... maybe this was a pack of bulbs that were... Oh, yes! I love those.
Right, what? What was it?
The what you're wearing right now.
My LED glasses?
Yes.
Are they? They're not... Oh, you know what? Did they... Oh, I think I left them on. I left them on, and they're out of juice.
We've got so many gadgets. One of my favorites was we had... this was Bluetooth month, where I had a glove that when you held it up to your head like this, it was still a phone. So you had a speaker in the pinky and a microphone in the pinky and a speaker on your thumb. And then
and Becky bought the LED gloves, which the fingers lit up.
Right. And then this little device, which was an IR blaster, which you could point a remote at and the app would learn what it was. And so it was a universal remote control. And so if you lost your normal remote, you could just pull out your phone and use this to send IR throughout the house, which I thought was really interesting. That was the Broadlink universal remote. We've done a lot of cool gadgets this year.
We have. Talk for 1 second. I'm just going to reach around and get my charging cable.
The LED gloves. Was that I know one year we had little LED fingers.
At the end of the glove, I think that was them.
Yeah. And, I mean, man, there have just been tons and tons and tons of gadgets this year.
Yeah. So this is, it doesn't quite, all right, so I forgot to charge these, but look at the bottom is blinking now to tell you that it's starting to charge. And when every one of these is lit up to the top.
It's fully charged.
It's fully charged.
That's
and
cool.
Then when you take the cable out and you talk, they're like graphic equalizer LEDs. They match your every word and bounce up and down with everything you say. Or if you're playing music, they light up to the music and you can see through them. And I could probably wear my magnifiers behind them.
Exactly. There you go. Another use.
Another use.
For those thin optics. Man, that's we have just covered so much in 2016. I guess let's wrap it up. Of course, yep. 2016 would not have happened without our patrons over at patreon.com. You guys support the show every single episode. By giving a little every episode we put out. Big, big, big thank you to you. 2016
yes.
would not have happened if it wasn't for the support.
87,
of you over at
we have done, this is our 87th show that the Patreons have allowed us to do.
Very cool. It was fun going back to some of the earlier episodes of 2016 to see the older studio and thinking, the new studio, you know, that all happened because of the patrons and just us being independent is all because of the patrons. Just, oh my gosh, thank you guys so much. So if you get anything from the Giz Wiz, consider giving back just a little bit over on Patreon.com.
Yeah, it could be 50 cents an episode, something, anything. We love it.
Yes, absolutely. And we even, if a reoccurring payment, which is what Patreon does, isn't your game, we also have a PayPal link at our website, gizwiz.tv. Speaking of gizwiz.tv, that's where you can watch the show live. We record just about every Thursday at around 4:30 Pacific, 7:30 Eastern time. You can go
next week. We're going
to
do a Tuesday because Wednesday I'm off to CES.
CES 2017 to see what the new gadgets are for 2017. Our website has links to, of course, the show notes that Dickie D writes up himself. All you have to do is click on the name of the gadget to Dickie D's write-up. And then click on the link to the side to find the gadget to buy it yourself. You can also subscribe on iTunes or YouTube. We have various versions available, audio, SD, HD, all of that available. And of course, you can find links to our Patreon there as well. But this is the last reminder to get on over to gizwiz.biz and play What the Heck Is It? They have what? 2 days? 2 days left?
Yeah, midnight Eastern Standard Time. So 2 days. If you're watching live at this moment, yes.
What the Heck Is It? This is the gadget. We're trying to figure out what the heck it is. And it'll be revealed next episode as to what this gadget actually does. There's 12 Mad Magazines for correct answers and 24 for clever, hilarious, interesting, and unique answers. Ones that use your brain to come up with what might this be used for? I think my favorite so far that I've guessed was that this was a Barbie dumbbell or for a scuba gear.
Oh,
for Barbie.
That's good. That's good.
So there you go. Get a guessing. This is the Mad Magazine cover that you'll be playing to win, which is the 20 dumbest people, events, and things of 2016. With that, I guess let's wrap up 2016. Thank you so much, all of you, for watching. Dick?
Oh, we should say we do have a couple videos in-house now.
Oh.
But don't forget, we do continually look for new videos. So if you have a video, 2 to 3 minutes, I invented this, I bought a piece of crap, I have an old gadget. We love videos of old gadgets. 2 to 3 minutes, make a video, put it on YouTube, click unlisted. That way only people you send the link to will be able to see it and send us that link. And as I said, we have two videos in-house, but we can always use more because people forget that we use one every week, and we'll start again using them next week. So thank you for that. And you'll get a Mad Magazine. Right now you'll get the February issue. If we use it in the next month, I have a 6-page Sully satire in that, and you'll get one of those 30 plus years or 35 year old Alfred E. Newman pictures if we show it on the show. And we've been pretty much showing almost everything. Ta-da!
Yeah, basically. It's almost guaranteed.
Ta-da!
You get an Alfred E. Newman picture.
Two to three minutes. Okay. Someone sent me a 13-minute video and said, feel free to edit this. Folks, we don't have the time to edit.
Just tell us about
video.
The gadget. Tell us where you got it, what you use it for. And
if you remember how much you paid for it.
Yeah, how much you paid for it. And maybe one or two things, you know, a feature or two. Not too much.
Yeah, that'd be great. That'd be great.
Thank you guys so much. From 2016 to the future, we'll see you next time.
I'll be here.